And back in July, he was a pretty typical little kid who had a headache. I'm talking with his parents, Freddie and Priscilla. And Freddie, I'll start with you. You brought your son here to Phoenix Children's Hospital because he was complaining of a headache. Then what happened?
Yes, I got home from work one day and he was on the floor and he was vomiting, holding the back of his head, screaming, asking me to pray for him. And he knows all about prayer and he has faith, but my wife was over him crying and she said, we don't know what to do. And earlier that week, we took him to two different hospitals that misdiagnosed him with a stomach flu and strep throat. And to not have an answer, it broke my heart. I'm sitting here saying, Lord, what do I do? And I said, honey, why don't you take him to Phoenix? Let's take him somewhere where they know what they're doing. And I got a phone call that night from my wife saying, it's not good. I don't have good news. We found an 8-centimeter tumor, massive, in the back of the base of his brain.
And he was in pain, and he was asking for help. So what happened? They performed the surgery here at PCH?
Well, when I got here, the doctors, you know, said, wow, this is very serious. You know, he can lose his life tonight. If he makes it, he may not walk, talk again. And, you know, the worst report ever. But I had confidence, and we got together, my wife and I, and we really prayed. And the surgery was supposed to take 12 hours. The good news is it took 3 hours. He said whenever he used the wand, he touched the tumor, and when he touched it, it fell on the table with no roots. It was not cancerous. And the very next day, he woke up screaming for Burger King.
Oh, my gosh. And he was just, that's perfect. He was just screaming for juice, too, and he got some. See, miracles do happen.
Yes.
So you were not sure, number one, if he would survive the surgery. Number two, if he would be a typical child and if he would be able to walk and talk and play like he is doing. So what kind of a miracle did PCH perform for your family?
I'm so thankful for this hospital that saved my son's life. You know, that night, my wife and I held hands and we prayed together and we were willing and ready to let go of our son. I said, honey, you know, let's be strong together. I love you. If this is it for him, then we have to be willing to let him go.
Yeah.
But whenever we released him and put him in God's hands, the very next day he was given back to us. And the hospital, the doctors were so amazing. The doctors prayed with us. They allowed us to pray for them. They get together, and the nurses were amazing. The
yeah.
nurses took care of us. The nurses loved my son, treated him as if he was their own. I love this hospital.
Yeah, Priscilla's the mom. She's sitting here. She's obviously not a busy woman. She has two other little girls. One is in her lap. One is in a stroller. You had your hands full when you came here with your son who was so very ill. What did it mean to you to be able to hand your son over to these people here?
It was hard at first, but I knew that, you know, this was the only thing that was going to save his life. And, you know, as hard as it was, I thank God that for these doctors, they're amazing. You know, to have to perform surgery on people, on little kids like this, every day, it's amazing that, you know, that God had his hand upon them, doctors, and I am so grateful for them.
When you have a child with a condition this special and this severe, you find other parents contact you, they find you on the internet, they hear through other friends that you had this experience here, and they might ask you for advice. You guys have kind of turned into little ambassadors, haven't you?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Who have you talked with around the world about PCH?
We've talked to just about everybody. I mean, we're hooked up on Facebook, and everybody knows about this hospital and what this hospital has done for me and my family.
You know, I have about 5,000 Facebook friends, and through this miracle and testimony of Phoenix Children's Hospital pulling my son out of a near-death experience, I've had at least 10 to 12 other people come up to me and message me telling me that this story inspired them. They themselves have brain tumors or cancers somewhere in their body, and they themselves are looking into even coming to Phoenix Children's Hospital, or they've already also been through this similar situation.
Yeah, that's exactly the kind of miracle that happens here at PCH. Freddie and Priscilla Hidalgo, their beautiful family, their son Jeremiah, a living miracle sitting here with us at Phoenix Children's. And I have to thank you. You're a very busy family. You came all the way from Maricopa to be with us tonight. It's not easy to do, but I know how important it is to you to talk about what PCH meant to your family.
Yes, it's so amazing for us. We're thankful for the opportunity. I can tell you that many people right now are listening about this story, and PCH has done the miracle, and we give all glory to God for what he's done for my son. I get to keep my boy, and I'm going to be the happiest dad. They said the doctor told me this, the best news I can give to anybody, I'm going to give it to you. He's going to grow up the rest of his life, he's going to live it, and he's not going to have to worry about this ever again. And I'm so thankful for
this
hospital saving my son's life.
He's a beautiful boy. You guys are a beautiful family, and I'm so happy that you found Phoenix Children's and that it is here for families like yours, because let's just face it, a family without this little boy is just not right. So give us a call right now. You know, become a miracle maker. You just heard about one, and you can help make another one for another family.
In one moment, they thought he had strep throat.
and the next minute they were preparing themselves for life without their child.
Life changes quickly.
And I wish, I mean, I can only imagine what the look on your face in your car as you're driving around listening to us right now on KTAR is, because I can see the look on the faces of every single one of our volunteers here at Phoenix Children's Hospital. Some of them had their hands over their mouth during that story. They had their hands folded as if in prayer in front of them. They were all listening intently to every word.
I can't even imagine coming home and finding your small, small child screaming, vomiting, and asking Dad to pray for him.
Yep. And I bet you've got that same look on your face right now as you're listening to that story. So.